Usually when you tell somebody you're an archaeologist, they tell you about this discovery of a dinosaur. Archaeologists don't dig dinosaurs, but that's a whole other thing.
Seconds of cycles.
My name is John Frey. I'm an associate professor of classical studies in the Department of Art, Art History and Design, and the Department of Romance and Classical Studies. As digital archaeologists, we're kind of shifting our focus. There's a lot of stuff that archaeologists have dug up over the last 50, 60, 70 years that has not been sufficiently published. The creation of digital formats, digital scanning of things, that's allowing us to sort of clear out some of that backlog. And it feels a lot more like detective work. We've been combing through a lot of the artifacts that were found in the past, the maps, a lot of the field notebooks, a lot of that digitized information. We think we actually have a what would be known in the ancient world as a gymnasium. It's kind of exciting because we know of one of these sort of practice running tracks at the site of Delphi, but the only other example we have of a thing like this is at the site of Olympia, the home of the Olympic Games. One of the most popular and famous of the sporting events was foot races. And the most famous and most important of the foot races was somewhere around 180 meters. That measurement is important because it suggests to us that this building that we think we have identified is directly associated with working out and practicing for athletic games.
Right here. So this is about 178 meters or something like that if done right from that little jog. So here, 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 and here. This is what we're talking about. So I actually,
The drone aspect is kind of neat. One of the problems at Isthmia was that we have a whole series of maps that are very, very accurate for specific parts of the site, but we don't have a very accurate map showing us how all those things relate to each other. Using the sort of widely accessible now digital technologies of GPS and drones, we end up with this very, very tight network of individual photographs that have been taken. We feed all of those photographs into software that takes all of the shared measurements from all of the photographs, and what we've produced on the other side is a highly detailed map of the site. Embracing digital does not necessarily mean forgetting about the analog past. It's about how can we update those documents in a way that doesn't replace them, but still adopt these wonderful new techniques of you know, openness and sharing and more accurate data collection. It can have an impact. It can produce exciting new results.